He knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
In this problem, you are helping your friend Lisa move out of her apartment. Despite your advice, she packed up huge boxes all the way to the top so that they are impossible to pick up, which means you will have to push them across the floor. There are 10 boxes, each with a mass of 50 kilograms, and you have to push them across a room with a length of 10 meters over to the door. Luckily, Lisa waxed the floor real nice, so it's frictionless and the boxes slide easily. Wearing your special non-slip shoes, if you push with a force of 16.3 newtons, how much time will you spend pushing all the boxes across the room and out the door? This problem involves motion, so we will need some kinematics equations. It also involves force, so we have to consult Newton's laws. If this sounds confusing, check out my tutorials on these topics in the Classical Physics playlist first. Otherwise, go ahead and give this a shot. In this problem, we are trying to figure out how much time is required to perform a certain task on the basis of some force we are producing. Therefore, the best thing to do is to use Newton's second law of motion, F equals ma. This will allow us to plug in the force exerted, as well as the mass of the box. That's all there is to it, because there are no other forces to consider, since we are assuming zero friction, and the gravitational force and normal force precisely cancel one another out, leaving just one force vector, the applied force. So we plug these numbers in and divide to get 0.326 meters per second squared as the acceleration that will result when you push a box with this force. Now, if you are generating a constant acceleration of this magnitude, how long will it take to traverse the 10-meter distance? Let's consult our kinematics equations. We need one with distance, time, and acceleration, as these are the three variables we are interested in. Let's try this one. Plug in 10 meters for the distance. Initial velocity will be zero since we are starting from rest, which means this term goes away. And the acceleration is the one we just calculated. That leaves this t squared term. We simplify and then take the square root of both sides to get 7.83 seconds. But wait, that's how long it takes for one box. Don't forget that there are 10 boxes to move. Just multiply by 10 and we get 78.3 seconds for the amount of time we will spend pushing all 10 boxes. So don't worry, just a couple minutes of effort, and then it's time for post-move snacks. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.